Good morning, friends. What is psychogenic ED? How do we diagnose psychogenic erectile dysfunction and what is the treatment? I am Dr. Ashish Agarwal, urologist, andrologist and robotic prostate surgeon from New Delhi, India. Today in this video, I will give you full information about psychogenic ED. To understand exactly what psychogenic ED is, first we need to understand what is the normal erection mechanism. So whenever there is some sensation of touch or sight or thought, the mind gets stimulated. The mind sends signal to the penis to increase the blood flow. The penis increases the blood flow, blood from the body goes into the penis to make it hard, and erection happens. Then at the time of intercourse, the erection maintains, and after ejaculation, the blood vessels again dilate and the blood from the penis goes back to the body, and the penis becomes flaccid. So this is the normal mechanism. Any problem in this normal mechanism will lead to erectile dysfunction. If there is problem in the brain not sending signal, that is called psychogenic ED. If the brain sends signal but the signal does not reach the penis, that is a neurogenic ED. If the signal is normal and it is reaching the penis but there is no increase in the blood flow, that is arteriogenic ED. If the signal from the brain is normal and it is reaching the penile blood vessels but the blood flow does not increase, it is called arteriogenic ED or arterial blockage. And if the blood flow increases in the penis becomes erect but the blood does not stay and it keeps on leaking and the erection goes down before time, that is called venous leak or venogenic ED. Today we will discuss mainly about the psychogenic ED, which is the mind. The main reason for psychogenic ED is anxiety or fear. There is performance anxiety that I am going for intercourse, will I be able to satisfy my partner? Patient has intense thought about it and the thought is so intense that instead of giving stimulatory signals to the penis, it gives inhibitory signals and the erection goes away. So what are the symptoms of this psychogenic ED? Firstly, it is sudden. Many patients will say that I was alright since birth and since a long time, but 5 days ago suddenly erection has stopped happening. So this type of sudden ED is usually psychological. There is no major cause for erectile dysfunction to happen suddenly. And if we ask in more detail, 5 days ago he had a fight with his partner, or he had a major financial loss, or he had stress in the business. So that is the reason for the erectile dysfunction. Secondly, psychogenic ED is situational. This erectile dysfunction is not all the time. Patient says that if I have intercourse in the house, I am not comfortable and I am not able to get an erection. But if I go to a hotel and have intercourse, I am able to have a good erection. Some people will say I have a good erection with one partner and I don't have a good erection with another partner. So this is also situational and it is psychological. If there is an organic cause of erectile dysfunction, it will be in all the conditions. Some people say that at the time of masturbation, the erection is normal, but when I go to the partner, then the erection goes away. Basically, it is because he is so stressed while going to the partner that the erection goes away. Many patients say that the erection comes, but it does not stay long enough, and as soon as I go to the partner, it is lost. So all these are signs of psychological ED. You see in this diagram, this patient, he had an erection and then in his mind he thought strongly about his erection. He thought so strongly that he sent the signal to the penis, and in this the penis gets down. So this is a classic example of how psychogenic ED happens, that the mind is giving so much signal that it makes the patient lose the erection. Now how do we diagnose psychogenic ED? Because psychogenic ED is a problem of the mind, there is no test which will show a positive result. But still, we have to do these tests to make sure that we are not missing out any other problem like an arteriogenic ED cause or a venous leakage. So we do two tests, one is the serum testosterone and the other is the penile Doppler test. In psychogenic ED, both the serum testosterone levels and the penile Doppler test are normal. Now, once we have diagnosed the psychogenic ED, what is the treatment? Like I told you that psychogenic ED is a problem of the mind. It is mainly related to anxiety. So, the first thing is that we have to modify our behavior. Whatever things make us more anxious, more uncomfortable, we have to avoid those. For example, if you are not comfortable in your house, you should change your house or you should go to the hotel and have intercourse. Secondly, if you have one partner which doesn't make you comfortable and you're not able to have erection with that person, but you're able to have erection and intercourse with another partner, so stay with that partner. Leave the partner which is causing you discomfort. These type of behavioral changes help a lot. Sometimes, apart from the behavioral changes, some patients need medicines to increase the erection and combat the psychogenic ED. Some people also take help of the P-shot or the shockwave therapy. But finally, there are many patients who have psychogenic ED. They have gone to their doctors. Doctors have given them medicines. Medicines have not helped. And when the patient has complained that the medicines have not helped, they have ignored the patient's request and just told them that it is in your mind. Please go and go home and there is no other treatment. And they are so distressed. They are having problem in their families. The wife is either starting divorce or has already left, and the patients are very depressed. So these patients who are depressed and they have tried medicines and still the medicines are not helping, then the best treatment for them is penile implant surgery. The benefit of penile implant surgery is that with the implant, you can have the erection at your will. You are not dependent on your mind to send the signal to the penis for the erection. So the benefit is that you can have sex whenever you want with whoever you want and wherever you want. You don't have to change the partner, you don't have to go to a separate area, you don't have to go to a hotel, you don't have to take those extra efforts to make yourself comfortable. Many times you make those extra efforts and still you're not able to have intercourse. But with the penile implant, you will be able to have intercourse whenever you want, wherever you want. So friends, I hope you understood what is psychogenic ED and how we can treat it. If you need any other information about the psychogenic ED or about penile implant surgery, you can contact me on email or WhatsApp. My email address and WhatsApp number are there in the description. Thank you.